Hey, what's happening, everybody? Welcome back. Today I want to talk a bit about Mortal Kombat 1. The stress test has ended. I was, of course, able to play a little bit of it thanks to the Thinny. I was able to try out Sub-Zero on Saturday, and he allowed me to like do one more tower, or two towers. So I did two towers. I tried Kenshi and Liu Kang, but for this video I'm going to be putting my thoughts out on Liu Kang. So I feel like I had a bit more creativity, or like was able to understand Liu Kang a bit more than with Kenshi. I can probably talk about Kenshi later on, but for this video I will be talking about Liu Kang. First thing I noticed when playing with Liu Kang in this one was he carried a lot of his moves from 11. Like, I know that's like a traditional thing for like a lot of characters in some games, but with this, it felt like he was pretty much ported in a way for how similar he was to 11. But I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, but it at least is easier to understand his playstyle. But I will say there were like a lot of unique visuals for his playstyle though, because with the fireball, as you can see, he had like, it's a combination of like fire and lightning, as well as when he does the dragon kick. Now whenever he does the dragon kick, he throws out a fire dragon construct, and once that hits the opponent, then he proceeds to do the dragon kick. I like that transition better. That way I feel like it's a bit safer, because like it starts out as a projectile and then it becomes an actual attack as well. It can also be amplified to do the the electric one. So when you do the electric one, it allows you to like pop the opponent up in the air to start juggling. I wasn't able to get like a bunch of pop-ups going, because I was still having it was like a connection thing. It was like through Parsec, but I was still able to have a lot of fun as is with a lot of the combos in the air, especially with the bicycle kick. That was probably the best looking move in my opinion for how it was being displayed. Because I liked how they changed it up for him, because normally when he does the bicycle kick, it's mainly like an actual like bicycle kick with animation where he's like just moving his legs in a cycling position, where with this, it's more like he's spinning his entire body to get the 8 kick scout, which I think is like a major improvement for its like display and damage. Started also for this tower, I did try to use Jax, and I did like his air grab he had, because you saw that in the trailer for the gameplay, and I also tried out his ground pound. So interesting thing about how the ground pound worked for Jax was if you did it, and you were on the ground, it would also hit you. So his ground pound not only hits you, but your opponent. So you're both going to get hit by it. So friendly fire is a thing possible for cameos, which I feel is a good drawback. So like it creates a little bit more balance between both you using it and your opponent using it. I'd say my only criticisms for it currently are how the movement is, because like I know like I was playing on a connection though, but I will say like a little bit of like dashing I'd say it needs improvements, as well as like moving backwards. I think movement is like the only thing that should be worked on, because like everything else is great. I think they just need to work on moving forward and backward a bit more, as well as like timing windows for getting pop-ups going. I probably don't have much to say on that, because like I still wasn't able to like get any air combos going, but when the beta happens in August and I can finally get a chance to do it, I'm pretty sure it's definitely going to be fun to finally try that out. I'll definitely play Liu Kang a bit more, but I definitely just want to see more of the cast, because we still need to see more of Kung Lao's gameplay. We still need to see Johnny Cage's gameplay, Scorpion's gameplay, and who else was there? Raiden and Melina. So there's still 5 other characters' gameplay that we have yet to see. So I'm curious on when we'll like get to see gameplay of each of those characters. Hopefully we get a combat cast soon enough so we get to see each of the characters in action, because I really need to see how they changed up my boy Kung Lao. So to end off the video, I'll let y'all just check out my gameplay, and be sure to subscribe. I'm trying to reach 35,000, and I shall see y'all soon.